that don't know what a mukbang is, it's usually when YouTubers eat, and the point of it is for you to join a meal with them. So if you don't have food in front of you or a snack or whatever, go ahead and pause the video and come back, or you can just watch us eat. Either way, it's fine with me. But yes, before we get started, please go ahead and subscribe to Yojo Unicorn. He is amazing. His content is fabulous. And yes, so let's get into the food. Joey and I both ordered large horchatas, which I can't remember what the ingredients is, but it'll be down there.
Like rice and milk.
Rice, milk, and
cinnamon.
Yeah, and I honestly never really liked it, but there's this restaurant close to our house that is freaking delicious. Also, because it's Taco Tuesday, we have tacos! So here's our tacos. I can't really zoom in very well, but we have two tacos de lengua and rice and beans.
I have two tacos de carne asada and then rice and beans. I really didn't like, I don't know. I got beans, although I'm probably not gonna eat them, sorry. I just never liked beans in my childhood.
He's probably only eaten beans like twice. And we also have quesadillas, solo queso. And let's dig in. So normally what YouTubers do is they talk to the audience. So, Joel, we can maybe start off by talking a little bit of like an update of like life, work, school.
Okay.
So do you wanna start?
My life has been pretty rough recently, let's be honest. Okay, so, cue sad dramatic music. So, basically, I thought I was supposed to graduate last semester, but people won't let me know because of my math classes. I needed 4 extra credits to graduate. I'm like, that's fine. That's literally just 2 classes. I would take summer classes, and then after that, I'll just go to a 4-year college. Well, I waited too late for the deadline to apply for the 4-year college, and then I needed a credit for science, so I had to take 3 classes instead of 2. So I honestly would have been so much better if I would have waited this semester and then I just went back in the fall. So yeah, and I'm taking 3 classes. Right now it's like okay, but kind of also it's kind of stressful because it's going like really fast. I'm like, oh no, I wasn't ready for this. Enough about my sad life, what about yours?
Mine isn't any less sadder, but so I did graduate. For those of you that don't know that, you can go back to a previous video that I did of life update and why I've been away from YouTube. But I did graduate a little more than a month ago. I did apply for one job and I didn't get it, but I try as much as I can, not always, as Joey's my witness, but I always try to look things positive. So I didn't get this job, you know, there's a reason why. So yeah, just gotta see what else God has in store for me. And so this week I'm planning on applying for one job at least, and just trying to clean around the house, get things done that I know I'm probably not gonna have a lot of time to do when I do work full time. But yeah, so no job here yet, but I'm not losing hope. So. Oh. Talking about job, do you wanna tell them about your future plans?
Oh, so. I think I'm gonna go to school as a pharmacist, so I have to wait a whole year before I can apply for the pre-pharmacy program, and then after it's a 2-year program, and then after that, then I'll be in the actual pharmacy program. Hmm. Yeah, I'm excited.
So you have a year left and then you're moving out?
I'm not sure. I mean, depends. And if I get hitched up, who knows?
If you're interested, go to www.yojounicorn.com/sugardaddy. So with the summer coming up, one of our favorite shows is about to freaking start and we're so excited. It's Big Brother 20. They just did a celebrity Big Brother and I'm happy that they are going back to regular people before celebrity again.
Yeah.
So is there anything you're looking forward to or think of any twists that Julie Chen is thinking of doing?
Okay, so I'm very confused because the person who cast the show, which her name is Robin Cass, I think she tweeted out something saying like it was not gonna be an All Stars. But when Julie Chen, she like leaked some stuff and it showed a star on her key. So like, if it's not All Stars, then what is it? Like, duh. Also, I gotta kind of rant a little bit because being a Robin Cass. Okay, so if you watch Big Brother Canada and Big Brother USA, you can tell that there is a clear difference between the cast between Canada and then between our Big Brother. Because with our Big Brother, it's all people in their 20s, abs, all pretty and beautiful, and maybe one old person that's like only like 30 or 40 years old. But in Canada, like, you have like a variety of people. You have a bunch of people of color, people that don't look like models. Like,
it's like comparing Taco John's and these tacos.
So, like, she gets smart on Twitter whenever people say, people that hire on Big Brother Canada need to do the same thing for Big Brother US. And she's like, I am the same person. But girl, look at yourself. You know you don't cast the exact same way as you do in Canada, okay? So, that's my little sass for the day.
My plan was to be on Big Brother this time around, since I'd just be graduating from college. Is there anything that you're looking forward to?
I just hope that it's not gonna be a bitter jury, because they literally ruin every single game. Like, I hate people when they say, I'm a fan of the show, but then at the end of the day, they vote bitter. Like, no, you're not a fan if you're gonna vote bitter. I feel like Big Brother Canada 6 was a bitter jury. US Big Brother 19 was a bitter jury. Big Brother Celebrity was a bitter jury. So I just hate this bitter jury. Mark my word, if I ever get in there, I will not be a bitter jury. I will make sure that the jury freaking votes for the best player that deserves that title.
Let's say that it is All-Stars again.
Mm-hmm.
Who would you want to come back?
People that played only once.
So you wouldn't want veterans.
Okay, I'm literally gonna go back on my word. But I really hope Danielle Donato gets to play again. Freaking loved her.
What did you like about her?
She was in Alliance, but she didn't like it. So she went back and like tried to create another Alliance. I like to see Jessica from Jessica and Cody play again. Cameron.
Who's Cameron?
First out on Big Brother 19. Very first out.
Oh.
Jody, I like to see her play again.
Really?
I think a lot of like the first out, so the people that never got the chance to play, really.
Do you think like the one who was with the racist one?
Aaron?
Yeah, the one who was with Aaron, that one guy.
Oh, David? Oh,
yeah.
No. I like to see Caitlyn play again, though. What about you?
Who would I want to come back?
Helen.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a good one. See, minus like the drama, kind of she was involved in, but kind of people were with her. Candace, but I feel like they're gonna go big or go home. You know, this is like season 20.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like they're gonna bring back like big people who did big moves, mm-hmm. You know? So if you could come up with your own player, who would it be? Or like, what kind of qualities would they have?
Like to win the game?
Yes. I would hope you would want your player to win.
Good on their social game and mental game. And won't necessarily win the endurance comps, but could. And also, someone that can win competitions, but they don't need to. And unless they absolutely need to, like it's a fight for their like life, then they can like win it, you know?
Now, would you consider any time you're on the block to be fighting for your life? Or do you mean like when they know they're gonna go home?
I would say like on the block.
Mm-hmm. I'd want somebody, let me do like Trish. I would want someone like Erica from Big Brother Canada, where she was great socially, everybody loved her, but she also was a comp beast, which I feel like it was bad for her, but she won competitions that she didn't need to. My favorite players are the underdogs, but not just like a floater underdog, not like an Andy, but like a floater underdog, meaning like someone who starts off quiet and then once it's like jury time, then they freaking come out of the shell and like win competitions and put people on the block.
Like Paris?
Exactly. Now in other news of shows we like to watch, Survivor Ghost Island just finished, and spoiler alerts for those of you that haven't finished watching. But what did you think about the season finale?
I didn't look at it. I mean, listen. So we all pick players for this game show.
And all our game shows that we watch too.
Yeah. Including like RuPaul, Race, Big Brother, Big Brother Canada. I had Dominic. So I wanted either Dominic or Donathan or Sebastian to win. No, Wendell won. And I felt like Wendell won because a bitter jury again. I don't know why. Okay, listen. I understand that Dominic and Wendell were like a pair and they were like together. But I feel like Wendell was more the bronze and he didn't really come up with any of the plans. I feel like Dominic was like in the front seat coming up with all the plans. And he was also a social player. And I felt like he could win some challenges. So I feel like he played a better game than Wendell. But I feel like the jury people that did better.
I totally agree with you. I feel that Dominic should have won for that same reason. He was the one talking to more people, strategizing, trying to figure out what was going to happen. While Wendell, I feel like other than winning games, he didn't really win much. But I will say, I was freaking shooketh when it was a tie. But at the same time, I wasn't. Because honestly, I'd kind of be a little upset if Laurel had won any votes just because she did nothing. She just followed these two boys around, you know? Like, come on, woman. Where's the woman power at?
I like Laurel because she was my player.
But if she wasn't your player.
I mean, did she deserve to win, no?
But you would have been happy if she did.
Yeah.
I really liked the whole Ghost Island thing of trying to reverse the curse. I just wish that most of the curses were undone. And now they have a new season of David and Goliath.
Mm-hmm.
Which, okay, but I don't know, maybe it was just me, but I still didn't really see a big difference of the people.
I think you just have to wait for their bios.
Right, no, personality. No, I get that, but I'm saying, like, from the example they give us, I don't really see. But I really want them to do zodiac signs, like, have a partner or something.
I eat so much food.
But did you really?
No.
So, if you guys liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe and press the little notification bell so you'll be notified every time I upload a video. Thank you for joining me in my first mukbang. I was so excited. I love this. And I know that the camera was a little weird, but it was the only way we could get all the food in the video. Hopefully, we will be able to do one on your channel. I'll be so excited with that. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. And see you guys again next time. Bye!